So it is yoga time. Welcome to Monday morning, all levels flow. It's 10 a.m. on a gray, chilly Monday morning. So it's a great opportunity for us to build some heat and strength. And for today's props, again, just two blocks and a blanket for the end of practice. If you'd like to use the playlist that I sent out, you're welcome to hit play on that now. We're going to begin on our backs. So find a comfortable position on your back. You might plant your feet or extend legs long. I'm just going to hit play on my playlist and I'll be right back. So as you come on down to your mat, you might like to place your blocks so that one is easily accessible to you by the side of your mat. And then the other one could be at the top of your mat where your feet are currently going to land. And then we're just going to lay down here on our backs as we drop into our yoga space, yoga time. You can gently close the eyes here. Begin to bring awareness into your physical body. Noticing the places where your body is making contact with the earth. Allow yourself to really release and relax here. Let's begin practice from a place of comfort and ease. And see if we can carry that sense of comfort and ease throughout practice. This means we'll be tuning in to the messages our body is sending us as we move. Noticing as things feel good. Noticing when we are challenged. And noticing if we push things too far. Knowing when to gently back out. To be kind and compassionate. Returning to that sense of ease and comfort. Let's take a big inhale and expand the arms wide. You might extend the legs wide, making kind of a star shape here, taking up space. Flexing and pointing into the toes. Wiggling your hands, stretching fingers, hands and wrists. Taking a deep breath in here. Send the breath into the belly. Really notice the belly expand as you inhale. And notice the body, the belly soften toward the spine as you exhale. This is our diaphragmatic breathing, which we'll use throughout practice. So we're consciously pressing the diaphragm down, which expands the belly, making space in the lungs for air. And toning the abdominal wall. Our core muscles support our spine and keeping them toned, strong, and flexible helps to support us through all of our movements throughout our day, on and off the mat. From here, gently rock your head to one side as you exhale. Noticing how that side of your neck feels. Breathing into this gentle stretch. On the inhale, bring the head to center. Exhale, dropping head the other side. Noticing any differences between the two sides. It's normal that the two sides of our body are different. Inhale, coming to center. Let's stretch the arms really wide, reaching from fingertip to fingertip, and then hug yourself, bringing right arm over left. Let the hands get heavy and hang by your sides. And let's bend the knees, planting the feet, and gently pressing the lumbar spine, the low spine, into the mat. So we can feel the full length of the spine pressing into the earth. Breathing here. And then reach your fingers to the shoulder blades, really feeling a stretch here in the triceps. And as you inhale, notice how the shoulder blades part as your back expands. Exhale, letting that breath go. We'll inhale, opening the arms wide, stretching fingertip to fingertip. Exhale, crossing the other way, left over right. Hands are heavy by our sides. Relaxing the arms to begin. And then reaching for the shoulder blades, taking this into a little tricep stretch and drawing awareness to the back body and how it responds to our breath. You can engage Ujjayi or ocean sounding breath and use this throughout practice. This audible breath helps us to stay attuned to our natural rhythm, which will guide our flow. Let's inhale, coming back to cactus arms and breathing. And then we'll draw the right knee into the chest. You might reach around the knee, extend the left leg long. We'll roll out the right ankle, lubricating the joint. And then on an exhale, bend the left knee and see if you can tuck it behind the right. So the legs are crossed. You can gently draw this crossed shape toward the body. From here, see if you can draw the shins closer to one another, pressing the energy inward. Breathing here. You might cactus the arms on an inhale. And as you exhale, bring the arms together, elbow to elbow and wrist to wrist, pressing the energy toward yourself inward from arms and legs. And then we'll release the arms down, interlace hands behind the neck. We'll drop the left foot down to the mat, cross the right ankle. And then we're going to draw this figure four shape toward the chest. You can keep your hands behind the head with the elbows wide and just use the energetic pressure from your left knee, drawing the right ankle toward the body. The right knee presses away. You also can reach with your hands behind the left knee or toward the left shin to deepen this stretch. Find what feels good. Finding ease and comfort. Trying all the options, experimenting and feeling some creativity and freedom of movement here. And then let's release the left foot down, uncross the legs. We're going to take the block between the two knees and draw the knees up so that the shins are parallel to the mat. We'll reach the arms overhead here. As you exhale, reach for your toes. Inhale, arms overhead. Exhale, toes. Inhale, arms overhead. Exhale, toes. Inhale, arms overhead. This time, reach both arms to the right of your right leg. Inhale, overhead, arms to the left. Inhale, overhead, arms to the right, reaching overhead and to the left. Release the spine long on the mat. Draw hands to the knees, and we're going to roll onto our left side, keeping this block pressed between the knees. So rolling all the way onto the left side, block between the knees, and then extend the left arm long, straight out from the shoulder. And then we'll open the arms into a T so that the right arm extends to the right. Our shoulders come down onto the mat, so we're in a spinal twist. Breathing here. Begin to relax the shoulders, relax the jaw, relax the neck. Observing how your body feels in this twist. Deep breath into the belly. Sighing it out. And then with arms in this T shape, see if you can move both knees back to center using core strength. From here, you might rock the knees a little side to side, giving your back a massage. And then we'll release the block down to the side. Plant the right foot, draw the left knee in, extend the right foot long. Beginning to open up our hips here. And then on the next exhale, the right knee bends and see if we can tuck it behind the left. So we're in eagle legs. Your legs are together at the knees, ankles might be far apart. From here, can you press the shins toward one another energetically? Excellent. And then we'll extend the arms wide into cactus arms, and then draw elbows and wrists together at the center. Breathing here. You can stay right here, just squeezing all the energy in. Or for a challenge on an exhale, lift head, neck, shoulders, and see if you can bring elbows to knees. Inhale, releasing down. Exhale, elbows, knees. Inhale, release. Exhale, elbows to knees. And release. Open the arms wide. Plant the right foot down on the earth. Cross left ankle over right knee. And we're in our figure four shape. So you can place hands behind the head if you liked that on the other side as you draw the right knee up, bringing the shin parallel to the mat. So energetically drawing the left elbow, ankle toward the body and knee away from the body. You can do this without your hands or try using your hands, maybe behind the knee or on the shin. Again, just experiment and see what feels good here. From here, let's release both feet to the mat, find our block, plant it between the knees, draw knees to chest, exhaling, and then we'll roll completely onto the right side, extending the right arm straight out from the shoulder, and then open the arms into a T so the left arm extends long to the left side. Shoulder blades are firmly planted on the earth. You have support between the knees. Breathing here, softening into this shape. Noticing how it feels compared to the other side. Finding the ease and comfort in this spinal twist. And then using core strength, can you bring the knees back to center? Remove the block. Let's reach for the feet and draw the feet up to the sky for happy baby pose. Drawing the knees toward the outer ribs and pressing the low spine into the mat. You can rock side to side if that feels good. And then we'll bring knees together and we're going to rock up and back three times. Rolling out the spine from tailbone to cervical spine. At the top of the third rock, come to balance in Navasana, boat pose. Legs parallel to the mat or toes down. The most important thing is heart lifting, core engaged. You can extend the arms long. Breathing here, relaxing shoulders down the back. Five, four, three, two, and one. Let's release the legs down and stretch them long. Coming to staff pose, palms plant by our sides. Sitting up nice and tall, flexing the feet. As you exhale, drop the head to the right and just circle the neck. Lubricating the joints. And then take those circles the other way. And then we'll inhale here, reaching out to the sides and up to the sky, really lengthening up out of the hips. Gazing forward, relaxing the shoulders down the back. Breathing here, finding comfort and ease. Feeling the length in the spine. And then on an exhale, let's hinge at the hips, reaching the heart forward until we come to our edge. When you get there, drop the arms down, lift the heart again, gazing forward. Breathing here. See if you can draw awareness into the back body, noticing that place between the shoulder blades as it expands on the inhales. On the next exhale, gently tuck the chin, rounding forward, dropping the torso toward the extended legs. Here's a great place for a strap. If you have tight hamstrings, you can use a strap here. Relaxing the shoulders, breathing. And then let's inhale as we come back to a flat back, hinging at the hips back to our staff pose. We'll bend the right knee, cross it over the left, drawing the knee into the chest and sitting up nice and tall. Inhale here. As you exhale, wrap the left arm around the bent knee and come into a spinal twist. Your gaze might be over the right shoulder. Inhale, lengthening the spine, drawing it closer to the knee. Exhale, twisting a little deeper. Inhale, coming back to center. Open the right knee, let it fall to the right side. The foot touches the thigh. We'll sit up nice and tall here. Lengthen arms to the sky, maybe the gaze lifts. And then we'll hinge at the hip, reaching toward the extended leg. Again, when you get to your edge, drop the hands. You can use your strap here. Deep inhale, this is Janu Shirshasana. As you exhale, tuck the chin, rounding over the extended leg. Relaxing jaw, neck, and shoulders, feeling that length in the side body. On the inhale, come back to a flat back, hinging back to seated. From here, we'll extend the right leg long, bend the left knee, cross it over. We're taking this to the other side. Sitting up tall, wrapping right arm, and on the exhale, twisting to the left. flexing into the extended right leg to activate the muscles, making sure toes point to the sky. Deep inhale, lengthening. Exhale, twisting. Inhale, returning to center. Uncross the leg, let the knee fall open. Sitting, getting your sit bones down to the ground. Inhale, reaching to the sky, finding length. Exhale, hinging at the hip as we fold toward the extended leg. Dropping hands down, using your strap if you like that on the other side. Feeling that stretch of the hamstring. And then we'll tuck the chin as we exhale, rounding over the extended leg, taking the stretch into the back body. Drawing awareness to the space between the shoulder blades. Feel it expand on the inhale. On the next inhale, come back up to flat back, rising back to seated. Extend both legs long. Plant hands behind the hips, fingers forward. Point the toes, press into the hands, lift the heart, inhale. Opening up the chest, the shoulders, the heart. You can stay here or on the next breath, press into hands and feet and lift the hips. This is reverse plank. And then we'll slowly lower the hips, bend knees, swing the legs around behind you, coming up to tabletop. Padding your knees with a blanket or doubling your mat. And you can come up onto your fists if you have any wrist sensitivity. Hips over knees, shoulders over wrists, core draws in. From here, as we inhale, tuck the chin, press the spine toward the sky. Feel the shoulder blades moving toward the earth as the center of the back moves toward the sky. On an exhale, draw the heart forward, arch the spine. This is cow pose. Inhale, cat, rounding the spine. Exhale, cow. Move at your own pace. Experiment. You might take C curves, looking over one shoulder and then the other, or rolling the pelvis, kind of like hula hoop position. These are all just spinal flexibility warm-ups to get us prepared for our flow. When you're ready, find some stillness and we'll step the hands one handprint forward, rolling forward to a modified plank, pressing feet into the ground, lengthening the spine, gaze is low. And then as you exhale, draw the knees in, elbows in, bend them tight. Lower all the way down to the mat, forehead to the mat. Slide the hands back to the low ribs. Press feet, pelvis into the mat. And on the inhale, lift head, neck, shoulders for low cobra. Exhale, dropping forehead to the mat. Slide the hands forward under shoulders. We'll inhale, lifting head, neck, shoulders. Maybe you go a little deeper. Low cobra. Exhale, dropping forehead down. Inhale here, reaching the arms forward, find your block and set it between the thumb and forefingers. So making L shapes with both hands. And then we're gonna grab the block. Set the block far so that your arms are fully extended. As you inhale, lift head, neck, shoulders, draw the hands energetically toward you, squeezing the block. And then drop the head down. On the next inhale, we'll do the same. Inhale, up, head, neck, shoulders, slide the block and the forearms to the mat. We're coming into Sphinx pose. Shoulders roll down the back. Neck is long, so the gaze is low. Pressing the pelvis and feet into the mat. From here, let's tuck the toes. We're gonna press up into a forearm plank. Breathing here, gaze is low to the mat. So we're lengthening the cervical spine, drawing the core in. And see if you can press that space between the shoulder blades up toward the sky. Breathing for 3, 2, and 1. Lift the hips. We're still on our forearms. We're gonna step the feet forward, coming into dolphin pose. Breathing here, hips reaching to the sky. You can pedal out the feet. Breathing for 3. Heart presses back between the shoulders, 2. Heels sinking toward the earth, 1. And then we'll walk the feet back to that plank, come back to our forearm plank, and slowly lower the hips down, untuck the toes, send the block forward, forehead to the mat. Bend the knees, you can windshield wipe them side to side. And then we'll extend the feet long, bring hands under shoulders, tuck the toes, and on the inhale, we'll press ourselves up to full plank. So the body is in one long line, heels pressing back, crown of the head pressing forward, breathing here, feeling our strength and connection to the earth. On the next inhale, lift the hips toward the sky, coming into downward facing dog. You can pedal out the feet, 1 and then the other. Pressing into all parts of the palms and fingers. Heels are behind the toes, so you shouldn't be able to see them. 1 big inhale here, expanding the belly, expanding that space between the shoulder blades. And as we exhale, let's roll forward to our full plank. If full plank is not your happy place today, simply drop your knees. From plank on the exhale, we'll lower halfway down to chaturanga. Inhale, lifting the heart forward, rolling shoulders back. This is upward facing dog. Exhale, leading with the hips, downward facing dog. Beautiful. Deep inhale. And a full exhale. We'll walk our feet to the back of the mat, our hands to the back of the mat, bending the knees and clasping opposite elbows, hanging here in ragdoll pose. Play with the weight in your feet. So notice where the weight falls. Is it the center, the balls, or the heels? Try and center the weight over the arches of your feet. Let the head be heavy. Shake it yes and no. And then release the arms, press into the earth as we rise, stacking 1 vertebrae over the next. Coming all the way up to mountain pose. Rolling shoulders down the back. Lifting the heart toward the sky gently and tucking the tailbone. From here, we'll reach our arms out and up to the sky. Lifting out of the hips, gaze can be lifted or straight forward. Do what feels good on your neck. From here, let's drop the right arm down, reach over with the left arm, coming into a side body stretch. Pressing down through the left leg, staying rooted, maybe spinning heart and gaze toward the sky. And then we'll inhale, coming back to center, reaching with both arms high. Exhale, dropping left arm, reaching over with the right. Spinning chest and gaze to the sky, if that feels good. Rooting down through the right foot. Inhale, lifting back to center. Exhale, let's cactus our arms here. And on the inhale, without arching a spine, we're going to press elbows and wrists toward the back of the room. Feel the shoulder blades come together. The tailbone is still tucked. Breathing here. As you exhale, draw elbows and wrists together in front. Stay here as you breathe. Sending breath into the back body. We'll keep the left foot, I'm not sure what's going on with my brain today. The left arm where it is. And as we inhale, we'll open the right arm to the right and twist our torso to the right. So the left arm stays fixed, the hips stay fixed, and we're simply twisting from the navel up. Breathing here, you can extend the arms long, make fists, and roll out the wrists. And then we'll come back to cactus arms. Inhale, as you exhale, both arms come together in front of the body. Deep inhale here. Exhale, we'll take twist to the other way, opening the left arm, right arm stays cactus and fixed towards the center line of the body, hips point forward. See if you can relax the shoulders into this twist. And then extend the arms long, fists, and circle the other way for the wrists. Back to cactus, elbows and wrists together. Inhaling here, exhale, let's press the palms together, send them down to the heart, and we'll bend into the legs for chair pose. So you should be able to see all 10 toes and lift them. And we try to take the arch out of the low back. The spine is long, so the gaze is low down at the mat. Breathing here. On the next inhale, step into the left leg as you lift the right, coming to balance. And from here, on the exhale, keep the knee fixed, and we're going to press the right foot toward the center line of the body. Inhale, coming to center. Exhale, the right foot out. Inhale, center. Exhale, in. Inhale, center. Exhale, out. Last time. In and out. And then let's draw the whole leg to the side. I know your legs are working. Press the foot toward your thigh and we come into tree pose. Opening up the hips with a balance. Sending our roots down into the earth. Eyes are on a drishti, a focal point. If you feel stable and want to experiment, you might interlace fingers and press the hands forward and up to the sky for a shoulder stretch. Breathing here for 3, 2, and 1. Kick the foot out. We'll step halfway up the mat. Hands come down to prayer and we draw the left knee up. We'll go through that rotation. So inhale here, exhale, ankle towards center. Inhale, center, exhale, ankle out. Inhale, center, in, center, out. Last one. You got it, Jane. Beautiful. And then we draw the knee to the right, plant the left foot for tree, sending our roots down into the earth. If you're having any trouble balancing, work on your foundation first. So make sure the standing foot is oriented straight forward and that you're pressing into all parts of the standing foot. If you'd like to grow your branches, you might interlace the unusual way, reaching arms to the sky, breathing, smiling. And then let's release the arms down, kick that foot out, step to the top of the mat, and we'll step right foot to meet the left, sinking our hips back for chair pose. Let's send the palms behind us, rolling shoulders back and pressing the palms together. And then if you feel brave, come up on your toes for hummingbird. Gaze is low, spine is long, breath is flowing. And then we'll sink the heels down, interlace fingers if you'd like, and we'll fold forward for Uttanasana. Breathing here, head is heavy, tailbone reaching to the sky, If you have the bind, the hands might reach to the sky. And then we'll release the hands down. Bring hands to the shin, come up to a flat back. Exhale, fold. And then we'll step the left foot back, dropping down onto the knee and untucking the toes. On the inhale, pressing up to Anjaneyasana, low lunge. Breathing here, pressing into the earth to lift up out of the hips. Inhale, lengthen the spine. Exhale, twist to the right, bring the arms wide. Gaze might come over the right hand. One more deep breath here. Exhale, coming back to center. Inhale, reaching to the sky. Exhale, drop the hands down to the ground. We'll send the right knee back to meet the left, coming into our modified plank. On the exhale, lower all the way down to your belly. Pressing feet and pelvis into the earth. Hands under the shoulders, we'll lift head, neck, shoulders for low cobra. Exhale, releasing forehead down to the mat. And then sending the arms forward, finding that block. On the next inhale, lifting head, neck, shoulders. And then let's drag the block toward our body, planting our forearms, and we're in Sphinx. Breathing here, gazing straight ahead or slightly down to lengthen the spine, pressing pelvis and feet into the earth. And then we'll tuck the toes, preparing for our forearm plank. On an inhale, lift up to forearm plank. Breathing here, body in one long line. On the next inhale, lift the hips, stepping the feet closer to the elbows for dolphin pose. Seeing how it feels the second time around. Holding the block between our hands helps us to keep our wrists fixed. We want shoulders, elbows, and wrists all in one line. So we don't want the elbows or wrists to be splayed out or in too far. If you're feeling like experimenting, you might lift one leg for a three-legged dolphin, and then lower that and lift the other. Lower that, and then walk the feet back, lifting the head for our forearm plank, dropping the knees and lowering down to Sphinx, removing the block, forehead to the mat. You can bend the legs and windshield wiper them here. Let's release the feet down toward the mat, slide hands under the shoulders if you're coming into up dog, or under low ribs if you're doing low cobra. On the inhale, we'll take our heart opener, whatever it might be for you. And on the exhale, downward facing dog. Looking to the top of the mat, let's hop or walk to the top of the mat. Inhale, halfway lift, flat back. Exhale, fold. We'll step the right foot back, dropping the knee down, untuck toes, press into the legs as we rise for Anjaneyasana, shoulders rolling down the back. Gaze can lift. Finding that sense of ease and comfort in this pose. And on the next exhale, let's twist our arms and torso open to the left, arms open wide, hips still point forward, breathing for 3, 2, and 1, coming back to Anjaneyasana. Gaze is high, exhale, hands to the mat. We'll left knee meets the right. We lower ourselves all the way down to the belly. Inhale, rolling shoulders back, lifting for low cobra. Exhale, forehead to the mat. Inhale, reaching arms forward, grabbing that block. On the next breath, drawing it towards us for Sphinx. And then we tuck toes, lift hips, forearm plank. Breathing here. And then stepping legs, small steps forward, coming into our dolphin pose. Breathing here, playing in this pose, seeing what feels good. Finding some comfort and ease, even in the challenging poses. And then we'll walk the feet back to our plank, lower the belly, lower the forehead. You can windshield wiper the legs. And then we'll bring hands under shoulders, lift the heart, low cobra or up dog, and then lift the hips, downward facing dog. From here, we'll walk hands back to meet the feet. Breathing here and Uttanasana. You might clasp toes with hands and inhale to a flat back, pulling against your bind. It's fine to have bent knees here. And then as you exhale, draw the torso closer to the bent, to the extended legs. Letting the head be heavy and long. And then we'll release the hands. Prepare your feet for chair pose. Hands come to the heart, we sink the hips and find chair. Deep breath in here. As you exhale, let's twist to the right. Take it to your degree. We've been doing some twisting already, so you might try hooking the elbow to the knee, but not if it brings your body out of alignment. And then check the knees, that the knees are parallel to each other. Inhale, coming to center. Exhale, twist to the left. Breathing here. 3, 2, and 1. Inhale, center. Exhale, rising all the way up, reaching to the sky. Exhale, mountain pose. All right. So we'll do some more balancing here. We've been working toward eagle, so we'll try eagle pose. So feet are together. Let's bring hands to the heart. We'll inhale here. As you exhale, sit in chair pose. Inhale, lifting the right knee. Exhale, sitting back in chair as you cross right knee over left. And then press the shins toward one another. Maybe you can interlace right leg behind the left. Hands can stay right here at the heart, or you can press them together, pressing elbows together, bringing elbows to shoulder height. If you've got that, you might scoop the right elbow under left, binding the arms, breathing here. 3 slow, intentional breaths. Expanding that space between the shoulder blades. Feeling the energy move inward. Feeling the roots sending down into the earth. And then let's unwind, kick it out, and step halfway forward. From here, the left foot will step down to meet the right. Sitting down in chair, hands to the heart. Inhale, lifting left knee. Exhale, cross it over the right, sitting back in our chair. Pressing left shin toward the right, maybe you can wrap foot behind calf, but the two sides are different. I mean, on this side, I can't today for sure. So do what you can do. Breathing here, you might press elbows together, wrists together, and then find the bind by scooping left elbow under right. Gaze is at a focal point somewhere low to keep the spine long, the neck long. 3, 2, and 1. Release everything down, kick it out. we'll step halfway forward to the top of the mat, right foot meets the left. Let's shake it out. From here, a little counter pose, another balancing pose. Well, from a standing position, let's step into the left leg, lift the right knee. We'll cross right ankle over left, let the knee fall to the side and sit back in our chair for figure four. The depth of your seat here is up to you. Do what feels good. We were internally rotating our hip, so now we're externally rotating. Balancing for three. Hands to the heart, two, and one. Pressing into the earth. Shake it out, step it down. All right, other side. Finding our grounded, steady pose, eyes on our drishti. Stepping into the right leg and lifting the left knee. Crossing left ankle over right knee, inhale. As you exhale, sit in chair. So again, when you look down, you should be able to see the right toes. Spine is long, so our drishti has shifted to somewhere low on the ground. And then the depth of this pose is up to you. Do what feels good. Try to match the depth that you achieved on the other side. This helps us to keep balance between the two sides. One more slow, deep breath here. Exhale, rising, kick it out, shake it out. Let's step our feet wide and just swing the arms, letting go of any tension, stress, finding the joy, ease, and comfort in our practice. Beautiful. And then we'll come to the top of the mat. Feet together, let's inhale, reaching up to the sky. Exhale, swan dive, lead with the heart, flat back, folding Uttanasana. Inhale, flat back, hands to the shins. Exhale, fold again. This time, step the left foot back. You can drop the knee down or keep it lifted, that's up to you. We'll press into the feet as we rise on an inhale for high lunge. I like to bring hands to hips, bend the back knee and tuck the tailbone, and then re-extend the back leg and lift the arms. Breathing here. On the next inhale, lengthen. As we exhale, cactus your arms and let's twist this shape to the right. Breathing for three, two, and one. Arms back to center. Let's bring elbows and wrists together. Reach them to the sky and then to the mat. We'll step right foot back to meet the left, finding ourselves in plank. Lower all the way down to the belly. Untuck toes, press feet and pelvis into the earth. Inhale for low cobra. Exhale, forehead to the mat. Inhale, reaching arms forward, finding your block. Exhale here. On the next inhale, draw that block towards you as you bring the forearms to the mat for Sphinx pose. Breathing here, spine is long so the gaze can be at your block. And then let's tuck the toes, lift the hips, forearm plank. Breathing for three, two, and on one, let's press the hips to the sky, stepping feet closer to the elbows. Dolphin pose. Pressing the heart back, lifting the hips to the sky, sinking the heels toward the ground, relaxing the neck. You can play with lifting one leg and then the other. If you're a more advanced practitioner, you might play with hopping one pressing one foot up in a prep for a forearm stand. But be careful and be kind. Let's walk the feet back to our forearm plank. Lower the knees, untuck toes, lower the pelvis, and then lower the forehead to the mat. Bend the knees, and you can windshield wiper back and forth. And then extend the legs long. Hands plant under the shoulders. Lift head, neck, shoulders for low cobra. And this time, let's press ourselves all the way back to downward facing dog. We'll look to the top of the mat, step ourselves or hop to the top. Inhale, halfway lift, flat back, and exhale, fold. On the next inhale, we'll step the right foot back, either dropping to the knee or staying on the toes. And as we inhale, let's bring hands to the heart and rise to our high lunge. Tucking the tailbone and bending the back leg to get our spinal alignment correct, and then rolling the shoulders back. Arms can stay here, or you might inhale, reaching them high, breathing for 3, 2, and 1. As we exhale, let's cactus the arms. Inhale here, on the next breath out, twist to the left. Breathing here in this spinal twist, pressing into the earth. Inhale, coming back to center, elbows and wrists together. And then let's reach the hands to the sky and reach to the earth. Plant the palms, left foot meets the right, and we're in plank. Stay here or drop to the belly. If you're with me here, let's lift the hips, pressing back downward facing dog. Deep breath in, slow breath out. And then we'll look forward, roll forward to plank, lower halfway down for chaturanga. Inhale, lift the heart, urdhva mukha. If you were on your belly, you can come into low cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. From here, we'll walk the hands back to meet the feet. Let's toe heel the feet wide, toes turn out, heels turn in, and we'll sink the heels, the hips down for malasana. You can use blocks to support your hips here. Palms can come together, or to reverse this shape, you can press wrists together, backs of the palms together. And then let's drop the head to the right, chin to chest, head to the left, chin to chest, and to the right. And then just make some slow circles at your own pace. From here, we're gonna plant the hands on the mat for Bakasana, crane pose. And I'll turn so you can see my alignment here. So our hands are at shoulder distance and our feet are in malasana position. Knees are pressing into the forearms. From here, I come up onto my toes, drawing the knees again tight into the arms. And then I send the weight forward and I'm gonna walk my feet toward the center. Pressing the knees into the arms, looking forward. You can experiment with lifting one foot and then the other. Or maybe if you're feeling strong, you can try lifting both feet for the arm balance. Keeping the gaze low and lifting the hips high. Breathing here. Great work, Jane. And then when you're ready, drop the feet back and sit in Malasana. We'll send the left palm to the left side and lift the right arm for a twist. And then drop the right arm down, plant the hand, lift the left. And then plant both palms. Let's bring them in front of the head and then stand as we turn the feet to be parallel to the outer edges of the mat, coming into a wide forward fold. Toe heel the feet together. We'll bend the knees here, bring hands to the heart, rising to chair pose. Just for fun, on the inhale, lift the right knee, cross it over the left, and we're back in eagle. Right arm under left. Gaze is focused on something not moving. You can stay right here, or you might slowly begin to lower elbows toward the knees. Nesting your eagle. And then inhale, slowly rising. Let's straighten into the left leg, unwrap. Kick the right arm out, step it halfway forward. This time let's swing the left arm, the arms behind us. See if we can interlace here for a little counter pose for the shoulders. Breathing here, you can balance on the right foot or keep the toe planted. And then let's bring hands to the heart. Step the feet together and sink down into chair. On the inhale, lift the left knee, cross it over for eagle bind. You can kickstand the toe or wrap it. And then bring arms together, left under right. Pressing into the earth, sinking the hips low. You can stay right here, or you might try dropping the elbows forward, hinging at the hips. And then we'll inhale, slowly rising, stand into the right leg, extend the left arm forward, unwind. We'll step the left foot forward as we swing the arms back, interlace the unusual way, roll the shoulders back and lift the heart. Excellent. We'll bring feet together here at center and let's take a vinyasa, resetting the spine, resetting the breath, reaching to the sky. Exhale, swan dive fold. Inhale to a flat back. Exhale, fold. Step back to plank or drop to the knees for support, finding ease and comfort. Exhale, chaturanga or to the belly. Inhale, up dog or low cobra. Exhale, downward facing dog. Let's drop down to our knees. Bring the toes together and the knees wide as we sink the head low. Forehead to the mat, child's pose. Scanning the body, noticing how we feel, noticing if anything has shifted in our physical body, in our energy, in our thoughts. And then bring hands under shoulders, knees together at center. And then reach the hands back toward the heels. See if you can clasp your heels. If you can clasp the heels, roll onto the top of the head as you reach for those heels. Breathing here, sending hips toward the sky, feeling that stretch in the traps. And then exhale, returning to child's pose. You might bring hands under the forehead into a pillow. Doing what feels good. On the next inhale, as you're ready, we'll press ourselves up to tabletop. And then walk the hands forward, lowering all the way down to our belly. We're coming into our back bend here. So we'll do locust pose. Let's send the hands back, palms face down by our sides. All 10 toenails press into the earth. The pelvis presses into the earth. And as we inhale, we lift head, neck, shoulders, and then lift the hands. If you can do all of that, this without much effort, you might try lifting the feet as well. Gaze is low, so we're keeping the cervical spine long. Breathing here for three, moving the shoulder blades toward one another, two, pressing into the pelvis, one, release everything down to the mat. Make a pillow of your hands. You can bend the knees and windshield wiper them. And then let's release the feet to the mat. We'll try a second time. Hand palms to the sides, face down. As you inhale, let's press into the toenails, press into the pelvis, and see if you can interlace hands behind the hips. If you've got that, on the next breath in, lift head, neck, shoulders, and draw the hands back toward the wall behind you. And if you have all of this, you can lift the feet as well. Breathing for three, pressing into the earth through the pelvis and hips, two, and one, lower everything down. You can turn one cheek to the mat. Let the palms face up by your sides. Let the body be heavy. You're welcome to stay right here, or you can try one more version. So you can take either of the two versions we previously tried. Or if you'd like to try bow pose, we'll begin by bending the knees, pressing hips and pelvis into the earth, reaching the arms back and seeing if you can connect to the feet or ankles. If you can do that without coming out of alignment, then take the ankles in your hands, press the ankles away from the body and use that pressure to lift the shoulders and then lift head, neck, and heart. This is bow pose. If you have this, draw the knees toward one another, pressing the ankles away to deepen the back bend. Breathing for three, two, and one, slowly release everything down, extend the legs, turn to the other cheek, let the body be heavy, the palms can face up by your sides. And then let's bring forehead to the mat, reach the left arm straight forward. And we'll slide the right arm under the left as we roll onto our right side body. From here, make a T shape with your arms. So the left arm extends to the left side and the left knee bends. So we're coming into a spinal twist. Then you can take your block and support your left knee. Spinal twists are the counter pose for back bends. They help us to release and relax. Soften into your shoulders here. Feel the right side of your body connected with the earth. And then see if you can expand that place between the shoulder blades toward the earth. Both shoulder blades resting on the mat. Heart is open. Inhale here. As you exhale, remove the block. You can bend, straighten your left leg and roll onto your tummy. We'll extend the right arm long, send the left hand under right and roll onto the left side of our body, taking that block for support under the right knee. And then bring the arms into a T shape, getting adjusted so that your both shoulder blades are resting on the earth. Letting the left hip and left leg feel supported by the earth. Right knee resting on a block. Softening into any areas of tension. Feeling a sense of ease and comfort in the spinal twist. From here, we will remove the block from under the knee, roll back onto your belly, hands under shoulders. Let's press ourselves to child's pose. Slow, deep breaths. And then we'll move into pigeon pose. So let's first come up onto the knees for a moment to set our props. I like to use a blanket to support my hips. You should do whatever feels good on your body. So set your supports toward the middle of the mat. And then we'll plant the palms, tuck the toes. Lift the hips for downward facing dog. On the inhale, slowly lift the right foot to the sky, three-legged dog. As you exhale, bend the right knee, draw it toward the right wrist and set the leg down, bringing the hips to rest on your supports. Making sure that both hips are hitting something. So you don't want to feel the hips floating off the earth. Check that your left foot is extended straight back from the left hip. And then we'll gaze forward, pressing the heart forward, deep inhale. As you exhale, tuck the chin, slowly walk the hands forward and come to rest. So I like to use a block under my sternum, but others like using a block under the head. find what feels good. It's nice to feel the torso, some part of the torso and the head supported. Sending gratitude and compassion to our body. Slowing down the breath. Letting our bones begin to feel heavy. Allowing muscles to soften and relax. Three more deep breaths here. When you're ready, slowly press yourself up. Tuck the back toes and lift the right leg. You can come into three-legged dog. Bend the knee and counter stretch, opening the hip. Plant that foot, lift the left, three-legged dog. Bend the left knee and send it forward, dropping the leg down and using your supports on the other side. Extending right leg straight back from the hip. Lifting the heart, deep breath in. Exhale, tucking the chin and walking the hands forward, bringing the body down onto your supports. Noticing the differences between the two sides of the body. Meeting ourselves with acceptance, gratitude, and love. Finding the places of for ease and comfort. Using our breath to relax our muscles. Deep inhale and a slow exhale. As you're ready, press the hands into the earth, lifting the heart, removing the props, tucking the toes for downward facing dog. And you might bend into the left leg and open that hip for a counter stretch. And then we'll slowly walk hands toward the top of the mat, lowering our hips, and then slowly lowering the body down to the mat for Shavasana. For Shavasana, I'm going to offer a gentle inversion using blocks and blanket. So you can set the blocks on the middle edge, making kind of a wall under where your knees will fall. And then place the blanket over that support. And then just bring the knees over the prop mountain, lowering down onto your back. letting the hands fall open in whatever way is comfortable. Closing the eyes. Letting the body be heavy and supported. Slow, deep breath in. Feel the heart rise, chest expand, the belly expand. And then let it go, softening and releasing toward the earth. Shavasana. We'll take five more slow, deep, intentional breaths here. Embracing that sense of ease, comfort, and relaxation. When you're ready, bring small movements into hands and feet. Slowly bend the knees toward the chest, giving yourself a hug. And roll onto your right side, pausing for a moment. Absorbing the sensations you find here. And then slowly press yourself up to a comfortable seat. Your eyes can stay closed. Lengthening the spine toward the sky, feeling rooted in the earth. We'll take a deep breath in and a slow sigh out. Let's bring hands to the heart in Anjali Mudra, a sign of our respect for one another. Sending gratitude for the practice of yoga, gratitude for the opportunity to come together in this way, in this time, gratitude for the wisdom that brought us here today. Thank you. Namaste.